Western Orissa celebrates Nuakhai festival with all pomp and show. 13 killed, 13 injured after bus skids off road in Jammu's Kiswar. 1994's ISRO spy case, Supreme Court voices, arrest of scientist Nambi Narayan unnecessary, orders compensation of Rs 50 lakh. Congress veteran and former Meghalaya CM D.D. Lapang quits party. Fierce encounter between police and Maoists in Malkangir. Good evening, you are watching Odisha Vision TV. I am Priyanka and welcome to the English Bulletin. Let's begin. A day after Ganesh Chaturthi, people across Western Orissa celebrated Nuakhai with religious fervor, devotion and enthusiasm today. The residents of Western Orissa are mesmerized in the beautiful festival, which is a grand festival of the region. They are celebrating this festival with great pomp and show. The festival began with the offering of a nabana, a newly harvested paddy, to Goddess Samaleshwari Devi in Sambalpur. Later, the people offered nabana in their preceding deities. A large number of devotees thronged the temple of Ma Samaleshwari, the presiding deity, to witness the traditional ceremony and seek the blessings of the goddess. While cultural programs are also organized in different areas of the festival, which symbolizes harmony and brotherhood. The festival is also observed in homes where the head of the family worship the household deity by offering rice and other food items. The prasad is then consumed by the family members. To mark the occasion, several cultural and community programs have been lined up for the evening. Apart from offering of new crop to the deity, the Nuakhai Juhar is a famous ritual associated with the festival. It is about exchanging greetings with relatives, friends and well-wishers. Prime Minister Narendra Modi, Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik greeted the people of Western Orissa on this auspicious occasion.
Died and 13 others were injured, 7 of them being seriously after a minibus plunged into a deep gorge near the Chenab River in the mountainous Kiswar district of Jammu and Kashmir today morning. The 25-seater minibus was on its way from Thaikrai in Keshwan to Kiswar. The mishap occurred at around 8:30 a.m. when the minibus veered into the road off and plunged into the gorge, the SSP said.
Local people were the first responders to the early morning accident before the police and the army rushed to the spot to launch rescue operations. Jammu and Kashmir's former Director General of Police, V.P. Vaid, who was recently transferred as the state's transport commissioner, had expressed his sorrow at the loss of lives. Dilapidated roads in hilly Doga region, coupled with official apathy and reckless drivers in overloaded vehicles, have turned this stretch into a death trap for commuters. Former Jammu and Kashmir Governor N.N. Vora, who had a 10-year-long tenure in the state, had repeatedly asked successive regimes in the state to improve the roads in the hilly state.
Friday voiced that former ISRO scientist Nabi Narayan's arrest in the 1994 alleged spy scandal was needless and unnecessary and ordered Rs 50 lakh compensation to the scientist who had accused the police of falsely framing him into the case. The top court also set up a committee headed by retired Supreme Court Judge Justice D.K. Jain to inquire into the role of Kerala police officials in the arrest of the scientist at India's space agency ISRO.
Nambi Narayan, who is 76 years old, had petitioned the court to seek prosecution of senior police officials for framing him into the alleged spy scandal. Reacting to the court order, Narayan said, "I am happy as justice has finally prevailed." The scientist was arrested after the Kerala police arrested Mariam Rashida, a Maldivian woman, on October 20, 1994. Though she was arrested for overstaying in India, police later accused her of being involved in a sex spy scandal. It was alleged that Rashida was the intermediary between the organization and two more women. She was accused of passing an ISRO psychogenic program secrets to the women, who in turn supplied the same to Russia and Pakistan's ISI. 2 years later, the CBI cleared all the accused who were discharged in May 1996. CBI also filed a closure report before the court, but a change in the government reopened the probe. The earlier consent given by the state to the CBI to investigate the case was withdrawn, and the Kerala police was asked to hold a fresh inquiry. In 1998, the Supreme Court squashed the state government's decision. On Narayan's petition, the Kerala High Court in September 2012 ordered the state government to pay Rs 10 lakh as interim relief to the scientist. Later, in October 2014, action was ordered against the errant police officials. However, a division bench reversed in the court in March 2015, which Narayan challenged before the Supreme Court. His grievance is that despite the CBI probe indicating the police officers, the state has not taken any action against them.
Congress in the Northeast, veteran leader and four-time Meghalaya Chief Minister D.D. Lapang resigned from his party on Thursday evening. In his resignation letter to the Congress President Rahul Gandhi, the 84-year-old Lapang stated that his resignation is due to the sidelining of senior party leaders.
He had earlier made it clear that he would not contest the assembly polls held in February this year. Lately, the AICC had been embarking upon the policy of phasing out senior and elderly people. In my opinion, it means that the service and contribution of the senior and elderly people is no longer useful to the party members, he stated in his resignation letter. This restriction made me frustrated and compelled me to be no longer comfortable to work in the party. Lapang also sent copies of the letter to 10 others, including Sonia Gandhi, Congress Meghalaya in charge and former Meghalaya Chief Minister and present Congress Legislature Party leader Mukul Sangma. The Congress had lost power to this National People's Party-led coalition, which includes BJP, in the assembly polls in February.
There has been heavy exchange of fire between the police and the Maoists inside the Tulasi Hill Forest area in the Maithili block of Orissa's Malkangir district since Thursday evening. Acting on a tip-off of the presence of the Maoist camp inside the Tulasi Hill Forest area, a team of district voluntary force and special operation group personnels led by Malkangir SP Ashok Meena began a search operation in the forest area in the evening.
During the operation, the Maoists, seeing the police, opened the fire on the force, which immediately retaliated. A senior police official at the district headquarters said that the cross-firing was on till this morning. He said, till latest reports, police had busted a Maoist camp inside the forest and seized a huge cache of arms and ammunition and several Maoist kits. The search operation is still on the track down the Maoists, who have managed to flee in early hours of Thursday. The detailed information would have been available only after the return of the police party to the district headquarters, the officials added.
And that's all for this bulletin. Before wrapping up the show, let's review the headlines once again.
Western Orissa celebrates Nuakhai festival with all pomp and show. 13 killed, 13 injured after bus skids off road in Jammu's Kiswar. 1994's ISRO spy case, Supreme Court voices arrest of scientist Nambi Narayan unnecessary, orders compensation of Rs 50 lakh. Congress veteran and former Meghalaya CM D.D. Lapang quits party. Fierce encounter between police and Maoists in Malkangir.
And that's all for this segment. For more information and updates, keep watching Orissa Vision TV. Thank you.